Right, George Cook here with Fabio Wardley. Fabio, first of all, how are you doing?
I'm good, thank you. How's things?
Yeah, good, thank you. Nice little draw with Leeds at the weekend. Loving life.
Yeah. Yeah, you did us a favour, to be fair. You did us a
Yeah.
solid.
You're welcome, as always. Obviously,
Cheers,
I had a
cheers.
lot to do with that.
Yeah, of course.
I'll take the credit where credit's
Yeah.
due. Obviously, last time I saw you, we were down at Boatsy versus Ease, where you had your fighting hands against Fraser Clark. What was that like for you? Obviously, there was a lot of people there, and it kind of got the atmosphere going a little bit when it was announced.
Yeah, it was good. It was nice to do it that way. It's always good from the fans' perspective as well to see a fight announced like that, see the two fighters rather than just like a poster going out and you just seeing it online or however, seeing the two fighters in the ring face to face, facing off like that. That's a good way to start off what has been a big build up to, obviously, what will be the 31st of March.
What was said in the ring? Because obviously I couldn't hear anything. I was just kind of put my head over to see what
Just
was going
peering,
on.
poking through the ropes and
And I was,
that,
what's going
trying
on? What's going
to.
on? So obviously peering.
I think I started off. I was just saying it's still too soon for you. Still too soon, however. And then I can't really remember what he was saying, to be honest. He was just saying, I think he was saying like, "Them belts come with me, or you're going to find out," or something. But nothing too crazy. A little bit of fun and games.
A little bit of fun and games, nothing too
You
bad.
know,
Not
a little bit
yet,
of a
not
laugh.
yet. Obviously, we've still got fight week. I think that's when it'll start to get a little bit interesting during fight week.
Yeah, I think it will definitely ramp up closer to the fight. Always does. Like when the fight's getting closer and fighters are a bit more angsty, not in the best of moods, a bit grumpy, a bit snappy and stuff. So say the wrong thing and everything might blow up and go
You best not be snappy with me on fight week, because I'll often like knock you out before you fight. You know
off.
what I mean? I'll just
Usually I'm
chin
all
you.
right to be. It's usually like the day before or like the 24 hours before where I'm a bit more like. But aside from that, I'm all right.
I'll
Me,
just
man, I'm good.
stay out your way on that one. Don't want my head getting knocked off. Obviously, like you said, it's been a long time coming. Are you excited to be back in the ring? So obviously it's been a few months now, you being out. Are you excited to get back in at end of March?
Definitely. There's no buzz like it being in the ring on the fight night, especially with a big fight like this, which will. By the time we get there, we'll have had the proper build to it, all, done all the right things to build a good headline fight as well. And the card itself is really good. So
Yeah.
there's a lot of things to look forward to on that fight night. So I'm buzzing to get back on there in the ring and perform again. It's my favorite thing to do and perform in front of the fans.
Obviously, Callum Simpson was on about fighting Ben Whitaker that night. Obviously, they both didn't have opponents. Do you think that would be a really good fight as well to have on that card?
That card is full of competitive fights. So to add another one into that would be great. I don't know if it's able to be done or however, but I know what Sky and Boxing want to do with Ben, and they really want to push him and promote him. And being in big fights like that is the right way to go about things. So maybe something like that comes off.
Obviously, we'll just go back to your interesting choice of t-shirt for the press conference, which got it going on Twitter a little bit. It was kind of discussed in the press conference and stuff. What was the reason behind the t-shirt? Was it just to stir up a bit of st get what was it called? Get the wooden spoon, get it stirring, get it going. You're a bit
It's
shiny like
to
that.
just poke the bear a bit and just stir the pot, like have a bit of a go. Like again, it's all in fun and games. It's obviously to do with how things went down the first time around when we were supposed to fight and obviously didn't, and Fraser pleads that he was under instruction from his management or whatever, things were out of his control. He wasn't allowed
You
to
believe
have the
that?
fight or however. I definitely believe he was instructed otherwise, but I don't believe that he had no control over it whatsoever. I definitely believe that they were trying to kind of not save him, but try to keep him away for a bit longer and try and nurse him through some easier fights and whichever and build him through a bit more. But I don't think he's like where he holds his hands up and say it was completely out of my control. I don't think that's true at all, no.
Do you think this is the right time for him to fight you now?
Doesn't matter because he can't back out of it twice, so
Mm.
it's the right time, wrong time, it's the time. It doesn't matter. Like he's already ducked and dodged away from it once. You can't do it twice in a row, otherwise he'll never live it down. So the problem with them now is he's backed into a corner. He can't get away from it. He can't drop out. He can't make up an excuse or anything else. We're here now, so we've got to crack on.
Who's the fight bigger for, do you think?
It's bigger for him because there's way more weight on his shoulders for it.
Yeah.
I said this a lot of time in the press conference of the announcement week and stuff, that like ultimately for me, I know I'm doing well and things are moving on really nice and however, and people are saying, oh, I can go on to do this and do that. But in the back of people's minds, there is always, oh, well, he's white collar, so he's going to fall at some point. Things are going to go wrong at some point. So people are always expecting me to go south. Whereas him, former Olympian, bronze medalist and stuff, they're expecting him to do big things. You look at the likes of like AJ and things like that, other Olympians who have come through previously and done big things in the sport, they're looking to Fraser to do the same thing. So a loss for him, especially this early on in his career, and then especially against an opponent like me, is damaging, really damaging.
How's camp been so far? I know you find it a bit of a boring question. You know, you are a few weeks out still, but you
Yeah,
know,
camp's been
how.
great. Training's great. It's the best camp
Well, who have
ever.
you been
Really good.
sparring?
Yeah.
Tell me who you've been sparring. I'm
I'm not telling you
interested.
anything, mate. Nah, look, it's gone really well. It has gone really well. Sparring's going great. I'm not telling you who, but it's
Okay.
going well. We're getting some good rounds in, as you can see. I'm putting myself through it. So, spar hard, fight easy. That's the motto of a camp. So we're training hard. We're putting all the work in and getting boxes ticked.
Do you think that's the one of the main key things for a good camp to get the harder sparring in so the fight becomes easier because you've kind of prepared for all different angles? You know, if you've got southpaws, you've got harder punches, you've got a bit of softer punches and stuff like that, it kind of prepares you for any scenario.
Yeah, like the thing is, it varies from fighter to fighter, I guess. Some people want to manage their camps differently and stuff. But with me, I like to really put myself through the test of camp and really kind of just run myself dry with it almost, and just think that. And then by the end of it, once you get to fight week and stuff, you can look back and be like, yeah, you know, I'm good here. I've ironed out everything that I could. I've ticked all the boxes. I've pushed myself all the way through. So ultimately, what happens on fight night is what happens now. So
Yeah.
I've done my bit. There's nothing left to be done, really.
What's the hardest part of camp for you? Because some people find it food, some people find it's not seeing their family and stuff like that, but what is it for you?
It's probably, yeah, it's missing social events, I think, for me. I make a real point of n anything that is unnecessary during camp, I try to stay away from. Or just like just try and be more just being in the zone of it all and be focused and training and targeted for everything. So missing out on stuff and not being around for stuff. A lot of my training team stuff are in different places as well. So I'm traveling a lot and I'm not able to be around as much with family and friends and stuff as I would want to. So that's always the big thing, but it just comes with the job. It's a sacrifice you have to kind of accept and choose to make.
Little grafter, aren't
You know me, just grafting away, just a
grafter.
boy chasing a dream, you know.
Oh God, not this again. I said before, obviously there's a great domestic clash to be had here, but what is next for you if you beat Fraser Clark?
It's hard, isn't it? Because it's always hard to plan in boxing. You never know what's going to happen or who's going to do what and who's going to end up where. I think the only definite thing is after Fraser, I'll be done with kind of the British boxing scene, British level fighters and things like that. It'd be definitely the right time for me to move on to international opponents of decent level. I think I'm top 10 in like three or four different governing bodies now. So I'm at the point now where I need to start picking a lane and choosing kind of what route I want to go down. Obviously, Fury Usyk and all the belts and stuff, and that's all going to happen. And then I'll have a rematch and stuff. So in kind of about a year, year and a half, something like that, then belts will start to fragment. So it's more so probably planning to make sure you're in the right position for something like that.
Got to wait your turn.
I don't mind. I'm young.
I know you say that this is obviously there's more weight on Fraser's shoulders, but he's seen as the underdog in this fight. Do you ever have the kind of underdog mentality of kind of, you know, I know you say you got like champions mentality and stuff like that, but some people like to go into the fights to take the pressure off themselves a little bit by seeing himself as the underdog.
I don't know if I even really view it like that. I don't really care for looking at it like that. Like, oh, I'm the underdog, so that's less pressure. I'm the champion, so that's less pressure, or it's more pressure, which I'm not fussed. Like, I don't, because again, I try not to fuss with all these little like A lot of people try and play with all like these different angles to look at it from, and like it has different weight and bearing on the fight, when ultimately it all means fuck all. Like, if I haven't, if I decide at the beginning of the camp that I'm the underdog and that's going to relieve loads of pressure, it's not going to change the fact that I haven't trained properly all the way through camp. Like, it's not going to make it any easier. But I only really put weight in the stuff, this physical, real, tangible stuff I can put my hands on and say, yep, I trained properly. So I know I'm in a good place. That's what any sort of stresses, any sort of worries or that will come from. They'll only come if I know that I've skipped sessions, if I've missed things I shouldn't have done, if there's stones that I haven't turned, basically. That's where they'll come from. I don't really fuss with the other bits too much.
Do you feel quite on track? Do you feel like all stones have been turned and that you are on track for your fight?
Yeah, definitely on track. There's still a few more to go. There's still still definitely some boxes to tick off. But for the most part, we're there. We're on the way.
Obviously, you were both asked in three words, to describe each other, and he referred to you as delusional. Why do
Call
you
me a
think that
prick.
was?
I thought he was going to start with that. Not very
Well, he
nice.
called you delusional. You were like intelligent.
Yeah, I know. I was like, oh, what am I doing it being nice? I thought, you know what? I'll give it medium. I thought I'll be all right. I'm not going to be a complete novice. And then I got called like delusional prick. Like, hang on, mate. Who knows?
What do you think he meant by calling you delusional, though? Like, what do you think the reason was behind that?
I think he's trying to say that because I'm so convinced that I'm going to beat him and that it's not ready for him, it's not the right time and stuff, that to him in his eyes, that's delusion, that I'm just not even looking at the facts of the situation, which is not true because I am. I just don't care for them. I still think I'm going to win and come through on top.
There really is bad blood in the fight now, though, isn't there? I think like it's kind of surpassed the kind of, oh yeah, look, let's try and make this a really good fight for people to come and buy tickets and stuff. I do think there is a little bit, it's getting a bit nasty.
Yeah, there's definitely some needle there now. Some things have been said that can't be unsaid. Some comments have been made and stuff. So we are where we are now, and it will only get settled on the night.
Well, we've got a half-time face-off tonight at Portman Road, your favourite place. It's like
Oh,
God's
up a
back
town.
garden.
Come on.
Between yourself and Fraser Clark, do you think the fans are going to get behind you tonight? I envision them going, like, get into him, fuck him up. That's the one thing that happened. Do you know what I mean?
I've seen a bunch of those comments on Twitter
I mean,
today. Everyone's gonna say, that's what we're gonna chant. We're gonna get that going.
that's the one chance that I could, like, prophesy him getting into you on that one. But what do you make of that, it being at Portman Road? Obviously, you absolutely adore that place for some
Yeah, no, it's
reason.
class. It's great because I've got such a good relationship with the club, such a good relationship with the players, and it's just so good that I'm able to mix those two parts of my life, which are so important to me, with boxing and football and the love of the club. But being able to bring them both together in the right way, and being able to like do the face off later on at Portman Road and the crowd and stuff, and people are going to go nuts. Like they always, even when I go down there normally and do things, there's always a bit of noise, always a bit of chanting and stuff. So especially once they see Fraser and stuff out there, there's going to be some choice words from the crowd, I'm sure.
I can't wait. I'm sure we are watching it. I don't even normally watch Ipswich. I'm not going to watch the game. I'm just going to
That's
watch before. I'm going to watch
a
Fraser.
lie, you definitely are as well.
No, I'm not. No, I'm not. Why would I waste my time? Come on now. You know what I mean? Like, I can't
I
believe.
don't know what you mean because we're sitting pretty in second and I don't even know where you are.
For now. For now. I think we're 21st actually, so.
Oh, okay, great. You crack on, yeah.
Don't even say that. Don't even start. Do you know what? You said you want to fight Portman Road by the end of the year, but who would you actually want to face? And because it can't just be anybody, it's got to be a cracking fight to have at Portman Road. It can't just be someone that you just think, oh, do you know what? Because it's at Portman Road, I'll just have it.
Someone I can just knock over and around
Yeah,
you or
you
something
could.
like that, you know, it'd be pointless.
Me? You think you could have me in a round? I swear on my life, I think you'd be in for a shock because I'd be in the heavyweight division as
Oh,
well.
Christ.
You'd be surprised. Let's see who the
Yeah,
fight.
like I'd definitely like to do it, like to have the fight at Portman Road, but I'm not one for doing it for the sake of doing it. I want it to be the right fight, have the right kind of momentum and build to it, and have the right feel to it. I don't want to just do it for the sake of doing it. I think that takes away from it. So
What if
again, it's an
Fraser was to
opposite we just
beat
have to
you?
look at. Hey?
What if Fraser beat you? Would you have a rematch there? I can't remember. I feel like that
I
would actually
can,
build
well,
well, you know.
maybe, but he'd be the champ then, so it'd be on
But
his terms.
yeah, but if money's money, in it, you know.
No, but I don't
Money
know if we'd do
talks.
it. Where's he from? Like Burton or something. So what ground or whatever? I don't know if he's too pally pally with his club or whatever. So we couldn't really do it over there. But who knows?
Pally Pally with his club. But I think, do you know what? If it had not been at the O2, obviously they're gonna put it at the O2 because it's a big fight. But I don't think, if it had not got as nasty as what it got, could have been a good fight apart from Road, I reckon.
Yeah, it definitely could have. Definitely could have. But it's Portman Road will always be there. Like I say, I'm really close to the club and stuff. So at any point where the right fight arises, and timing wise, obviously doing it in the at the end of the season and things like that is obviously when it has to be done. So if all those bits align, then it will always be an option.
Well, I've got to ask you quickly about obviously AJ and Ngannou on Friday. We're getting closer now. You know, they're both looking in really, really good shape. AJ's obviously over in the UK now, predominantly training with Ben. Obviously trained for the Otto fight with Ben, but obviously there wasn't really enough time to see the whole product of AJ. Now we're going to see that against Ngannou. How do you reckon the fight's going to go?
I think it'll be, I don't want to say comfortable to take away from Ngannou at all, but I think it'll be a relatively comfortable and composed performance from AJ. I think he's looking really, really good and just sure of himself in the ring. He knows what he wants to do, he knows his objective, and he feels confident in himself. And you saw that translate really well in the last fight. So I think you'll see that carry on through. Like you say, he's had more time with Ben now to work and get things lined up and all in order. So I think you'll just see more of that in the Ngannou fight. Whether he'll get him out of there or not, he's definitely got the power to do it, but Ngannou's a very, very tough man, so we'll see.
Finally, have you got a message for your fans and the people who are coming to support you?
Look, thank you to everyone who's already bought tickets. If you haven't, get some, get there. It's going to be a massive night. And then to all the town fans, all the boys I'll see tonight, catch you later on as well.
Well, another finally, because obviously you love another finally. This is nice, actually. I was going to say best
Finally.
luck in your fight and best luck to the Tractor Boys this evening, but because you just rolled your
Hey.
eyes, I thought Bristol beat you now just because you rolled your eyes at me like that. I am going to watch the game now. I'm going to be going, whoa, Bristol. Just because you said
Class,
that. Yeah.
class. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Yeah, let's see how you do under pressure. Oh.